we head to the polls next week, state leaders say Mississippi may face hurdles implementing voter ID this year. 16 WAPT Scott Simmons is live at the state capitol with why there's a holdup. Scott.
Well, two reasons, really. Money and Justice Department approval, both needed to implement a voter ID plan here in time for the fall elections. Some lawmakers here at the state capitol have their doubts.
A voter ID measure passed with 62% of the vote last fall. The Secretary of State now claims he needs $500,000 to put cameras in every county courthouse in the state and to provide free voter IDs to those who need it.
And I certainly believe that it's political in nature, and I think that this is designed from the top of the Republican Party all the way down to the state level and local level.
Do you think voter ID will be implemented, will be funded?
I hope not. I pray not. I believe that the Justice Department will prevail.
Representative Tyrone Ellis from Starkville and other critics are hoping the Justice Department will step in and stop the state's voter ID efforts.
I respect his opinion and he's right to it. But that said, again, we voted on voter ID and we're in the implementation process.
But Secretary of State Delbert Hoseman has not submitted a plan to the U.S. Justice Department yet. He says he needs lawmakers to approve the funding for the photo IDs first, then the Justice Department to approve the plan by July for the voter ID process to be in place by the fall presidential election. Hoseman says fraud cases like this one in Canton involving six people accused of absentee voter fraud as an example of the need to watch the election process. Hoseman is pushing a measure this session that would limit a person to only help 10 people cast an absentee ballot.
Where we get into trouble is where we have like 163 ballots witnessed by one person.
My reaction is it's an overkill. It's trying to kill an ant with an elephant gun.
Well, Hoseman estimates between 5 and 10,000 people in the state of Mississippi would need one of those voter IDs to be able to cast a ballot. Hoseman says he's trying to follow the state of Georgia model that had its voter ID plan approved by the Justice Department and learn from what South Carolina did wrong to have its rejected. Live at the state capitol, Scott Simmons, 16 WAPT News.
Well, Scott, one more time, tell me again why we have to get approval from the Justice Department just to implement this voter-approved measure.
Well, remember, this really dates back to the civil rights struggles of the 60s. And since that time, of course, the federal government has had mandate or approval over our election process. Any major changes has to be approved by the feds.
All right, Scott, thank you so much for that information.